Hello all of you. So now in the last class we have done the design of single angle section and also the plates. Okay, so now we'll go for the design of double angle section. Here is the problem. A tie of roof truss consists of double angle ISA 100 by 75 by 10 mm with longer leg back to back connected on either side of gusset plate with a 20 mm diameter, that is the diameter bolt. Okay, determine the strength of the tie. So in the roof truss you will have so many members, maybe single angle, double angle also. In the double angle section means it will be maybe the top card members or the bottom card member. Okay, here they have clearly mentioned it is a double angle section, that means it is a 2 ISA 100 by 75 by 10 mm. So now here you need to find, you will have the area over there. Area, you will get it from the steel table. Steel table 2 ISA, you need to search for 100 by 75 by 10 mm. Then you will get this area. This is from the steel table. So finally, we need to find out the strength of the tie member. So first, you need to find out the strength, means you need to have the three main things. That is strength of the section in the yielding, rupture and block shear. These three things you need to find it out. Okay, so now we'll find out one by one. As in the question, number of bolts is not mentioned. First, to go with the proceed with the problem, we need to find out the number of bolts. Then only you can go with the next of the procedure. Okay, so now TDG is equal to AGFY divided by gamma M naught, that is the tension capacity, that means yielding capacity. This formula you have it in the code book. It is in page number 32. Here you have in the page number 32, you have the AGFY divided by gamma M naught, this equation you have. So it is the yield capacity. Okay. Fine, we'll substitute it now. AGFY divided by gamma M naught. AG you have already got it from the steel table. You substitute it. FY is 250 divided by gamma M naught is 1.1 into 1000 is nothing but whatever by the value you get, it will be in newtons. You need to convert into kilonewton, so you need to multiply it by 1000 in the denominator so that you will get 750. Okay, this is the tension capacity of the member before yielding. So as in the question they have mentioned, with the 20 mm diameter bolt. Okay, so here diameter is mentioned, we need to find out the number of bars. That means to find out the number of bars, first we need to find out the shear capacity and bearing capacity. You have studied in your second module, design of the bolted connection. Okay, same way you leave to find it out here also. You need to find out the shear capacity and bearing capacity. So to find out that D naught, you will calculate, that is 20 plus 22 is equal to 20 plus 2 is equal to 22. Okay, next 2 will be the clearance. Next, we'll go for the values, that is shear and the bearing strength. To find out that, first we need to find out whether the section is in the single shear or double shear. As it is a double angle section, you will have the double shear. Just as your butt joint, it will act. So here you can take NN and NS as equally 1, or you can take NN as 2, NS as 0, or you can take NN as 0, NS as 2. Whatever it is, if you add these two, you need to get 2 because it is a double shear. Okay, so now divided by square root of 3, all this equation you already know it. So that if you find out to substitute everything, you will get the 103.3 kilonewtons. Next, we'll go for bearing strength. To find out the bearing KB value, we need to know. So we'll calculate what is KB here. KB is equal to E divided by 3 times of D naught. So you will get as KE, I'll take it as 1.7 times of D naught. P, I'll take it as 2.5 times of D. So that you will get what is KB. You have four values, 4 equations to find out KB. So here are the two points. We got it as 0.61 and 0.51. Next, we'll go for another two, is FU divided by FY divided FY. So that you will get it as 0.98. So now, and another is 1. Okay, so in this 4, which is the least, that will be KB value, that is 0.51. So next we'll go for substitute everything in the equation and you will get it as 81.6 kilonewtons. So bolt value is 81.6 kilonewton because it is least. Next we'll find out the number of bolts. As the load is not mentioned, yielding will be the final load, right? Strength of the member, tensile strength. So 750 is the load you need to take, divided by the bolt value will give you number of bolts. We got it as 9.23. We'll round it off to 10 numbers. Okay, so now this is about the number of bolts. Next we'll go for the design strength due to the rupture of critical section TDN. So it is, I told you, three values you need to find it out. So this will be the second one. Okay, so now to find out in the rupture, you have it in the equation, in the code book. You have the equation in the code book, that is in the page number 33, clause number 6.3.3. Here you have single angles. Okay, in the single angle, you have it TDN is equal to 0.9 ANC FY divided by gamma M1. You have this equation, right? And here you have beta value equation. Here the unknown is beta. So here you have an equation to find out it. And what is W and BS? Everything you have it in the code book itself with the diagram. So BS is equal to, this is W, this is W1, and the thickness is this thickness of the gusset plate, that is angle section, and this is for welding. Okay, so to find out this, you need to find out first what is BS, W, everything. Okay, so first we'll find out what is all that. So BS, just now I showed you, right, that equation is there, and it is 75, and the outstanding is 100. Okay, so that is the connecting leg, outstanding is 75. So this 60, you will get it in steel table. Okay, so now BS is W1 plus W minus 10. So you will get it BS. Next will be a W. W is nothing but the length of the angle in the outstanding leg. So outstanding leg is 75 and thickness is 10 mm. LC is nothing but, see now, here you have from the, suppose if you have 4 number of bolts, for example I am talking about, four bolt you have, that is from first bolt to the last bolt, that we call it as LC, or I'll take it as LC. Okay, so how many number of bolts we have it here? How many number of bolts? We have 10 number of bolts. In 10 number of bolts, how many spacing we will get? 9, right? So 9 into distance between that is pitch is 50. Okay, here you need to take number of spacing. Okay, so number of spacing is 9 into 50 is pitch distance. So that you will get 450. Now you got all the values to find out beta. Substitute everything in the beta equation. You will get it as 1.3. Next, we'll go for Fu gamma M0 divided by Fy. Why we have taken here is, in the beta equation, here you have a condition. Okay, this condition should be satisfied, and you have one more equation, 0.7. That is the point, 0.7. Whatever beta value you get, that should be greater than 0.7 and lesser than this value. Okay, if you calculate whatever you get, that should be lesser than this value. Okay, so now if you find out beta, we will get it as 1.3. So now you got it as 1.3, right? So now 0.7, and if you substitute everything, you get it as 1.44 for this equation. 0.7. Which is lesser, 0.7 is lesser than 1.3, and 1.3 is lesser than 1.44. Our condition is satisfied. If suppose the condition is not satisfied, suppose you get it as 0.5, beta value you got it as 0.5. The condition is it should be greater than 0.7, but we got lesser than 0.7, means you need to take 0.7 and continue with the problem. Okay, and then if you go for 1.44, okay, suppose whatever the value you got it here, if it is greater than this, but actually speaking, it should be lesser than this value, right? If suppose if it is greater, take whatever the value it is there here and continue with the problem. Okay, so next, A and C is equal to, first again we need to find out areas here, okay, A and C and AGO. Okay, A and C is nothing but area, net area in the connecting leg, gross area in the outstanding leg. So net area is nothing but here, this is the connecting leg. Here you have the bolt hole. That means in a, it is not a solid plate now. Some of the plate as that we have drilled out to make the hole. That means you need to minus everything and that will be the net area. Gross area is here you don't have any bolts and it is completely area you will get it. So now A and C is nothing but area, A is nothing but the length. Towards this I will take this as an A, that is 100 minus D naught is 22 minus T divided by 2 into T. You will get A and C. Next, we'll go for AGO. AGO is B minus T times T minus 2. B is nothing but outstanding leg is 75. Why I am minusing T divided by 2 is, suppose if you take an angle like this, okay, if you take an angle like this, from here till here it is 70 and again from here till here it is 50, right? So if you want to, if you just leave this, if you want to find out the area of this is 70 into 6. For example, I'm talking about 70 into 6. So you, this complete area is done now. But when you talk about, when you calculate it, this portion, what happens? Again, whatever the hashed portion is there, you will take it twice, right? So we need to minus half T divided by 2 towards this and T divided by 2 towards this length. Okay, so that is why we need to minus T divided by 2 so that you will get the answers. Got it? So that is about A and C and AGO. You will get these two answers. Substitute everything in this particular equation. Why I am multiplying by 2 the whole equation is, whatever the equation you have, it is for single angle section. You need to calculate it for double angle section, right? So you need to multiply it by 2. This is the only change with your single angle section. Okay. So TDN is equal to 2 into 0.9. That equation, substitute everything so that you will get it as 844.63 kilonewton. By multiplying it by 2, because it is a double angle section, equation is for single angle section, so you need to multiply it by 2. Next we'll go for block shear. Check for block shear. It is in page number 33. Okay, in page number 33 you will get this equation. See here, page number 33, clause number 6.4.1. So TDB is equal to, you have two equations over here. Whichever is least in these two equations, you need to take that and you need to design. And it is also given for a single angle section, whatever. So, but you are calculating for double angle section, right? So the whole equation, you need to multiply it by 2. And again, same here, you need to multiply it by 2. That will be for double angle section. Okay. So now, to find out that, to basically first we need to find out several areas. AV is nothing but area towards the parallel to the load applied. So load is applied in this direction. Parallel to that, that will be LV. Okay, length LV. That means from the end till here. From end means you will get the edge distance also, right? So that is 40. Edge distance, I have taken it as 40 plus 9 times 9 into 50. 9 is spacing, how many spacing we have, and the pitch distance from one bolt to another bolt is 50. So that you will get from the edge, that is from the end till here, middle of this. So that is LV. Okay, 9 into 50, you got it out. Now, next we'll find out AVG, gross area. AV into T, that will end up the gross area. Next we'll go for net area. Net area is nothing but, you need to minus the bolt holes there. Okay, bolt holes is nothing but, very easy, simple method is, how many number of bolts you have, that you need to take and you need to minus at the half on the edge. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 bolts you have, right? 10. In the 10, you need to minus half here. That means 9.5. 9.5 is in this direction. Half will be in the other direction, perpendicular direction. the last class I showed you that paper, right? Same thing, same concept here also, but the bolts are laid in only one single lane. That is the only difference. Nothing else is different here. Okay, it is very simple. How many number of bolts you have? If you are confused with that, how many number of bolts you have, that if you minus 0.5 you do. Okay, so that you will get this. This holds good, this trick holds good only if it is the bolts are laid in a one single plane. If it is in the two single plane, one you need to minus. Okay, AVG minus 0.95 D naught into T. So that you will get this answer. 9.5 is 10, you have minus 5. Now ATG is nothing but in this direction area. ATG is equal to LT into T, 40 into 10. Next, this 40. Okay, next ATN is equal to ATG minus 0.5 D naught into T. Okay, so now how did you get 40 is, it is in the steel table. You will get this in the steel table. Next, ATN is equal to ATG minus 0.5. The other 0.5 is left out in the perpendicular direction. 0.5 D naught into T. So 400, everything you substitute here, you will get this answer. Okay, you got all the areas now. Substitute in the equation. TDB is equal to, so whole equation into multiply by 2 because we are designing for double angle section. Okay, so now we got it as 1139 as the least one. So this is the one part. This value is for the block shear. Okay, least of these two is this one. So this is the block shear strength. So but when you calculating, you need to check for all the three values. So for block shear is 1139. For rupture is how much? 844.6. And for yielding is how much you got? This is 750, right? This is 750. So least is how much? 750, right? So that will be the design strength of 750. Okay, for basics of all this, how to take what is the numbers and all, you need to just watch my previous video. You will get to know how it has derived and all, 0.9 and how I've just briefed it out. This I just wanted to show you what is the difference between a single and double angle section. This is the only difference you will have in double angle and single angle section. This you will get it from steel table 40. So that is about the difference between that. Still more explanatory you want, you just watch the previous one. Okay, thank you.